city of Europe, ils sont venus par Agora. Donc c'est des gens qui se font venir.
So, again, welcome everybody. I'm really proud to announce that Franck Biancheri, the founder of AEGEE,
it may be time for AEGEE members, AEGEE delegates, students in Europe in general, to come back to some basics and to try to understand why they need to work together and how they can occupy the future of Europe. Before defining what AEGEE should do, what AEGEE can do, you need to know in which environment AEGEE will have to work. And that will be the first part of my contribution. The second part will be about what are the opportunities, what are the possibilities for youth movements and citizen movements in general in Europe in the coming years. And the third part will be about AEGEE, AEGEE's future, AEGEE's organization, and the ability for AEGEE to use these opportunities of the coming years. And there, I will tell you things that many of you will not like. And the last part will be with you. It will be the discussion time, question time, opinion time. 2012 is the year when the European project, especially centered on Euroland, is going to move from a crisis time to a rebirth, a renewal time. Then will come, in 2013-2015, a reassessment and reorientation of the Euroland-EU foreign relations. Less NATO, less transatlantic relationship, and on the contrary, a very fast move towards the BRICS. It is already happening, but under the surface. What will be the difference between 2013 and 2015 is that it will appear on the agenda, on the political agenda, on the geopolitical agenda. And then, and that's where you are going to be definitely crucial, in 2014-2016 is coming the big democratic rendezvous between Euroland, EU, and its citizens. But in France, in Spain, in Italy, everywhere in Euroland, we are seeing that the people are not going to accept for long to be spectators of policies which are now affecting their pension, their health system, their education, their jobs, their salaries, and so on and so on. So the 2014-2016 time will be the time when democracy and Europe will have to find a way to come together. But it's exactly one of the points where students, citizens, and Europe have definitely a role to play. There is a political entity which is emerging. And this Euroland is not going to be based on the Brussels system, on Brussels model. It will be made much more of networks, networks linking national administrations, national ministries, with a strong European coordination. It will be made of transfer of powers on European level, but not necessarily backed by big machines behind. That is the new kind of work and operation you are going to see in the next 10 years. And it will be a strong process. Why? Because the UK itself alone has put itself completely out of the game. When for two decades, the UK was the power trying to slow down and to prevent these evolutions to happen. The Eurolanders will keep on using the EU institutions when they need, when they can. If they can't, or if it's too complicated, new institutions will pop up in the coming decade. And when I speak about Euroland, let's be clear, I don't speak about Euroland today only. In 3-4 years' time, most countries of the EU will be into the euro. So Euroland is in fact 25, 26 countries. So you have to think that this is the core group which is going to shape the future of this decade in Europe. Europe can make the difference because Europe makes the majorities. When we side with the US, the West has a majority. When we side with the BRICS, the Euroland BRICS has a majority. So we are the kingmakers inside the G20. There is nothing like one European. A European is a team of Europeans. This is valid for the leadership of Europe, as it is valid for AEGEE, by the way. This is the only way you can imagine a European. It's a team of people from different countries, not one single man or woman. The De-Brussalisation also. We need to take out the European leadership for one city. I know what I'm talking about. I'm French. And France right now is dying from the hyper-centralization of the French system. And Brussels was built and made upon the French system of the 50s. The same disease provokes the same consequences and symptoms. We have to get rid of the French-based centralistic system invented 50 years ago for managing the EU. Students and youth movement have two pillars in Europe. The first one is about European education. You are legitimate. Every minister, every commissioner, every European MP will be absolutely finding you relevant, legitimate, if you come with ideas, proposals about this topic. The same comes for democratization. You are young citizens, so you are also legitimate when you talk about how to get the citizens in control of the way Europe is moving. On these two, politicians cannot refrain themselves to be tempted to support you, to give you their patronage, to give you subventions, to give you visibility. You need a levy. Even Archimedes needed a levy to put the world on top. And you have something which has appeared in the past 2 years, which is a levy of a huge potential. It's called again Euroland. You have there something which I can tell you we have been missing for many, many years. A place where there is a clear convergence of interest, preoccupations about economy, social issues, education, politics. Outside of this area, and countries who are going to join this Euroland, nothing will happen regarding European integration. This is outside. There is no levy, no interest from politicians, no support from medias, no money to be put into supporting projects and so on and so on. So don't make the mistake to try to move the world from sand. Try to use a stone and to put your levy on it. And this stone is Euroland. Then the point. Forget enlargement. I told you, I will tell you things you will not like, some of you. That's part of the game. Forget enlargement and similar EU priorities of the 90s, 2000s, because they are just dead. It's a two-sided situation. The enlargement dream of the 90s, 2000s is absolutely finished, which requires, therefore, to build new kind of relations. It doesn't mean no relation. It means other kind of relations between these groups of countries which used to be at one point interested by enlargement and the Euroland and EU. Occupy the future. Again, all around the world, I occupy Wall Street, occupy that, occupy this, occupy Vatican, occupy Brussels, occupy Paris, occupy that. They are locations. They are the past, the present at best. When you are a youth movement, when you are a student movement, the one thing you have to occupy because you can do it, because you have to do it, is the future. That should be your focus. How can you improve, how can you increase this capacity to feel the future, to explore the future, to take risks, to do things that people don't do anymore when they are 40, when they are 50, when they are 60, and so on? This should be the thing you have to dare to do every day, or at least every meeting, and so on. Which means, clearly, Have your objectives clear. Few objectives, very clear. Otherwise, you don't occupy anything, you get lost. Second point, take risks. Do things that the rest, the others, the older ones, tell you are impossible. If I was, any time I was told what you are doing, Franck, is impossible, I have stopped, I mean, AEGEE would have not even existed. I told you it was eurosclerosis at that time. I would have said, Europe doesn't interest anybody. It will never work. Well, you are there 27 years later. So somehow, somewhere, it has worked. So we don't hesitate to do what the older ones, other people tell you is impossible. Never surrender. I don't play Churchill. But never surrender your objective to any institution objective. Rather than having an office in Brussels, make a show of force every year in Brussels. Make a big congress. Bring students from all over Europe and make a big thing just next to the parliament, next to the council, next to the commission. And I can tell you the next morning, you will have a much better position to negotiate partnerships, sponsoring, money, patronage, and so on and so on. Institutions are like co. They are sometimes skeleton. But they also like co in the way they move. You can talk to a co for hours. Will not make much of a difference. Or you can just give a pick in the back. Maybe the co will move. Think of that, and you can understand the way you can make institutions move. If you are a network of builders, you attract builders. If you are a network of users, you attract consumers. There will be always a majority of consumers, tourists in AEGEE. But you have to strengthen the builder size to make it go from 10% to 15 or 20%, because this is the engine driving the organization. And last point, that will be a big shock. I think that if you confront the key question of the end of the 90s, 2000, enlargement vision of Europe, and the return of the integration on Euroland, AEGEE will have to face the question of building two different networks inside itself. One based on the Euroland, Euroland 26, so with Poland, Hungary, and so on and so on. And a non-Euroland network, non-Euroland 2016-17. And I think we'll not be able to avoid that. Why? Because I know from discussion with some of you that it is already an issue. That you feel that the motivations, the interests, the questions, the agendas of people from these two groups are diverging. Today in Euroland, students, young people, politicians, medias have a focus on a certain number of things which are meaningless or almost meaningless for people outside. And the same is true as well. So what I'm saying there is not to break AEGEE. It's to make AEGEE Europe an umbrella. But inside, within this umbrella, to have two sides. Who maybe in 10, 15 years will be merging again, I don't know. I'm not a prophet. So, please, don't play the ostrich. Don't hide and blind yourself. This will be tough discussions, but these will be discussions very helpful. Not only to decide the future of the organization, but also for each of you to understand better what you stand for and what you can make for the best out of what AEGEE is today and what AEGEE can and should do if it wants to make the best out of the past 25 years for the next 25 years. So now, I hope it has been useful, I don't know. It was a pleasure for me. And if you have opinion, questions, aggressions, I don't care, it's time to do fine. Thank you.